Hey guys, it's Nate, aka The Foot Accountant. Welcome back to the channel. Monday, Market Outlook. We're going to take a look ahead at this week in foot, talk about what could be coming content-wise, as of course we are in the middle of the winter refresh promo, and there's a lot of stuff that could be coming this week, so I want to talk about it, get you guys prepared ahead of time, so that we can be looking ahead, maybe make some investments, possibly look at some market movements, or maybe sell some cards before they could drop, as a part of this winter refresh promo, and then other things that are happening this week in FIFA and in real life, because we have Champions League football back. Finally, after what has it been like a 2-month hiatus of no Champions League football, we're going to have some of that back too, and that's going to be a talking point today for some of those investments we could be looking at, and also Road to the Final cards as well. But I want to first start talking about the promo that is going on right now, which is Winter Refresh, which at the moment, it's looking pretty bare, right? How many of these new SBCs have come out since the start of Winter Refresh? We had Player of the Month Haaland, which is not really a Winter Refresh. We had an Icon Moments kit that costs you like 20k to get, and we've had one pack SBC that's been here for one day, 17 hours, and that's basically been it. And then today we got the 83 plus guaranteed. So in terms of SBCs, during Winter Refresh, it's been kind of a letdown. Honestly, this promo so far has just been kind of just not much. The focus has been on these prime icons and the prime moments icons, and that's kind of it. Like, that's been the focus of this promo, the moments icons, and then of course some of these new cards that are on the game as well. Let me check the price of Ericsson just because I'm curious at the moment. These Winter Refresh cards, it looks like they're getting hit with some supply right now, because I'm recording this during Squad Battle Rewards. That was like 15, 20 minutes ago. So it looks like we have a little bit of supply on these Winter Refresh cards at the moment. If you're looking for a buy time for these, wow, Ake is 188. Interesting. Ariel is 58. I think some of these guys will rise out of packs. Again, they're kind of rare. And as we know from last year in foot, second half of the year promo teams, those cards are very good to trade with and very good to, they fluctuate a ton, basically. And this team, I think, is not going to be an exception. I think they're going to be pretty rare, pretty easy to trade with, and I think they're going to rise out of packs as well. But these cards fluctuate on the daily. I posted a tweet this morning of this Maxwell Cornet. This guy fluctuates 10,000 coins every morning almost. Check this out. Last night, I bought him at like 58, 59,000 coins, and I ended up selling him for 70K a couple hours later, overnight for me, when I had them listed up. So that was a GG. He was 60, 65K all day. Now he's back down to 56. When will these guys be their lowest? We'll probably look at that later in the week. I would expect that these guys would get a little bit lower towards Thursday rewards, especially if we get some big time SBCs coming out this week, which we'll mention in this video too. Then I do think these guys will get cheaper. So I would not worry about buying these cards if you want one for your team. I would hold off on that. Zlatan, Bruno Fernandes, Ake, Schultz, whoever you're looking at to buy for your team, I would hold off on these cards, because I think there's a possibility for big SBCs later this week, and also just some pack supply SBCs with Champions League content. We'll probably get some of those as well. I would hold off on buying any of those cards until later this week. Prime Icon Moments, a lot of people want to try these cards just because they're freaking cool, right? They got big time stat boost, and to be honest, I think that the supply of these cards is a lot. I think these cards are actually getting supplied on the market, which means people are packing them, and it means people are making coins from them. So that, you know, it interests me a little bit that these cards are getting so much supply. Look at this, almost a full page of Ian Wright Icon Moments. Only 2 days of lightning rounds. That just really tells me. I mean, even a guy like Kaká is on the market consistently. This 92 Kaká, yes, he's expensive. But we have five cards up on the market, and this is arguably one of the biggest stat boosts on an icon we've seen. Major, major stat boost. Really, really sick looking cards, 6 million coins. But still, to have five of them on the market is pretty interesting to me. So I think these cards are getting supplied at the moment, which is interesting. We'll continue to see those prices fall and see those prices drop as we go on through the next couple days. But again, these cards are fantastic to trade with. I got a Giggs today. I don't know if you saw it on my Twitter. I posted a picture of my buy price on Giggs, 970,000 coins. I ended up selling them for 1.175. That was like 140,000 coin profit right there. I bought this at 1 mil flat earlier in the morning on Sunday and sold it for fresh for 1.097. So that was a nice profit there as well. And then some other flips. But this market is still very good to trade in. So this week, as we are getting content, Champions League stuff, there's going to be tons of market movements with Road to the Finals. I would say that if you're trying to make coins, there's still going to be opportunities to flip cards this week. There's going to be a lot of panic selling. There's going to be a lot of undercutting on cards, especially some of these cards that are going to be playing this week in the Champions League. And if we want to move on and talk about these now, I think this is a good little segue into that. Road to the final cards. Of course, this week we do have some Champions League games. And I'm going to find these road to the finals on the market for you really quick. But the thing we have to take note of is that these are the games that are being played today or Tuesday and Wednesday this week. There's not that many games that are happening, right? Only a few of these are happening. We only have four games that are happening this week. And then after that, next week, we have some other first rounders, our first leg matches. But if you're going to be looking at Road to the Final cards, any of these cards or Europa League cards, all the Europa League guys play. But if you're going to be looking at the Champions League cards to either invest in or to be watching them fluctuate while they play, make sure you look at cards from these four games right here. Tottenham and Leipzig, PSG Liverpool, Atlanta Valencia, and Atletico Madrid Liverpool. So I said Liverpool twice, PSG and Dortmund. I don't know where I said Liverpool twice. I said it in there, I think, though. Whatever the case. Watch these four games. These are going to be the only ones that fluctuate this week. And there's going to be big time price movements with these cards. And I want to talk about these a little bit just to kind of prepare you guys on what to expect for these. So let's say right now, Jadon Sancho is 175,000 coins for his Road to the Final card, which is technically his best version on this game, I believe. 87 rated, very similar to the stats of the center attacking mid card, right? This card is 170,000 coins right now. This card, what it's going to do, it's going to rise a little bit into the game because people are going to realize you kind of have to use some real life football knowledge when you're trading with these cards. People know that Dortmund are playing well right now. They also know that PSG has not been playing very well. So they're probably going to be buying up this Sancho card before the game a little bit. I would expect him to be up to like 185, maybe 190K before game time on Tuesday. Because people are going to maybe start thinking that Dortmund has a chance to win this game. And of course, whoever wins these games on Tuesday, seriously, if there is an outright winner for any of these four games and any of these four games next week as well, these Road to the Final cards will get an upgrade. Now, if Dortmund and PSG draw, Sancho will not get an upgrade, or Gay won't get an upgrade. But if either team wins, the Champions League cards and only the Champions League Road to the Finals will get an upgrade for winning the first leg in the round of 16. Since the Europa League games are in round of 32, they actually have to move on to after the second leg. So the Europa League cards will not get upgraded this week, right? So like, let's say Roma wins the game against Ghent. They have to go and beat Ghent again, wherever that game is, right here, on the 27th, and then Juan Jesus would get upgraded. So that's just something to think about. The Europa League cards get one less upgrade, I guess you could say, because they have to play the round of 32, and the Champions League cards get boosted after the first leg at the round of 16, and then the winner of the round of 16 to whoever moves on. So that's just something to think about. So if we're looking at games this week again, we've got Sun, who's going to be getting upgraded possibly. We have Leipzig. Do we have any Leipzig ones in there? We might. Valencia, we have Was. Atlanta, we have an SBC Gomez. I don't know if he did that. PSG and Dortmund and Atletico Madrid and Liverpool have the most. Like, Mane is in that one. That's going to be a team that's going to be playing, of course. Sancho is going to be watched. Was is going to be somebody that's going to be looked at by a lot of people on this game. Road to the Final set two. Cards to watch this week, of course, Militao and Bale with Madrid playing. This is an SBC. Party is going to be a card that's going to be moving a bit on the market if they can somehow. This is another thing that's going to happen this week, boys. Let's say Atletico Madrid can somehow manufacture a goal first. If Atletico Madrid score first, this Party card is probably going to jump to like 120, 130,000 coins. He's going to jump up big time. Big time this card is going to jump up, because if they go ahead in the game, then people are going to start thinking this card's going to get upgraded. So that's something to watch. And then on the other end of things, if Atletico Madrid go up a goal, Liverpool would be in the position where they could lose. So that's where you might see the Road to the Final Mane card drop a little bit. So basically, these cards move up and down drastically in the game when goals are scored. So make sure you have notifications on for goals, even if you're not watching the games. Like, if you're watching a game on a live stream, you won't see the goal right away. But if you have notifications on for like a SofaScore or a FlashScore app, on your phone, which where's mine? Somewhere. Then you'll get notifications when that team scores. You might be able to pick up a card, and once you see the goal scored, that card might go up 30, 40,000 coins, and then you can sell it, right? It's really, really risky. It's kind of like trading with ones to watches after they score a goal, but it's also very, very fun. So watch some of the panic on these cards. And of course, let's say PSG beats Dortmund. This Sancho card is going to take a hit in price because he's not going to get upgraded. He still could have a chance to get upgraded depending on what the score is, right? And after Tuesday and Wednesday, we'll be looking at some of these Road to the Final cards if they get too low, because we know that they're going to be playing again in a couple weeks. And not really like a short-term investment type thing, but if these cards get so low, we might have to look at them for a possible rebound, because of course, like let's say PSG beat Dortmund 1-0, Dortmund would still have a decent chance of getting through the group if they can win the next game and get recover the goal deficit as well. They will move on and go past in the next round, so they would still get upgraded. So that's just something to think about with these cards this week. What else is going to come out with Champions League content? Well, Champions League rare cards and non-rare cards are probably going to be needed as well. If I were you guys, I would look at this week's game and look at some of the squads, right? We know that we're having Dortmund and PSG. So marquee matchups is always a hit for the Champions League SBC time frame. And that's why I was mentioning to you guys as well to keep your eyes out for a possible supply on the market of these cards. Even like right now for squad battle rewards, catching these guys on bid might not be a bad shout. Getting on some of these, just stocking your club with a few of these Champions League rares and non-rares, because they probably will require these for SBCs. And if I had to guess for a marquee matchups, they usually pick one game from each day. So I would say marquee matchups is probably going to be Dortmund and PSG, and then Tottenham and Leipzig. That would be my guess for like a marquee matchups type thing. But we will have Europa League and UEFA marquee matchups for this week. So that's something to think about as well. But the main thing that I think about with those SBCs and what's coming out with those is pack supply. I honestly think that the biggest thing I'm worried about with those marquee matchups is pack supply coming onto the game, because what that means is there's going to be these winter refresh cards are going to be getting packed when those SBCs are out. That means the prime icon moments are going to get a little bit of supply this week, and then other stuff in the game is going to be getting supply. So that's something to just kind of keep in mind as well. If you like investing in that stuff, look into buying some of those teams that are playing this week, some of those Champions League cards from those teams, or even the rare golds from those teams as well. Other stuff that could be coming this week in FUT. We talked about Champions League. That's a big, big thing. I think there's also a potential for big-time SBCs. We talked this in my video yesterday about the Neymar Player of the Month, right? We talked about Neymar Player of the Month. How is Neymar's inform doing right now? Let me check this really quickly. Neymar's inform is about 2.1 mil. Let me make sure I didn't leave any out there by searching that. It's such a tight range. Neymar's inform is right now about 2.14. So he's down a little bit, just a weekend league sell-off type thing. But I do think it's a possibility we get Neymar's Player of the Month this week, whether it be at the beginning or at the end of this week. I'm not entirely sure. Player of the Months are always tricky, right? We can really guess the Premier League Player of the Month because they always release it on a Friday. But some of these other Player of the Month seem to be kind of released at random times. So watch out for a Neymar Player of the Month SBC this week. There could be some panic on icons because of that. There could be some panic on these Neymar cards. So I would expect to hear that a little bit talked about more as we go on through this week. So just kind of watching that could cause some market movements this week as well. The Neymar SBC. And of course, if we do end up getting a mid icon SBC, I know a lot of you guys right now are invested in these high rated golds, which are still pretty low. Honestly, they're still very, very low, but they're not going to go up until we get SBCs. And so far for this promo, we have not gotten any SBCs. That's another thing. Last year, if you remember, like the Manolis, what is it, it was like a UCL premium SBC is what it was called. It was the purple card with the white stars in the background. I haven't seen that card added to the code yet, but there's a possibility that we will get some moments SBCs, like a player moments SBC, like the Arthur that we have right now in the store. And also the possibility for a flashback SBC for Champions League type content and for Europa League type content. We got that last year as well. So just be on the lookout for actually more SBCs this week. Because right now, so far, this promo has been pretty abysmal, to be honest. Just been focused on new cards that have been put in packs, the new upgraded cards, and whatever else they're doing. They're refreshing League SBC, which is cool, I guess. But other than that, this promo just seems kind of, you know, average in terms of content. So if you're holding on to high rateds right now, if you've got some high rateds, if you did a club stock, if you're unassigned, hold tight, wait for those SBCs to come out. That's why I don't really encourage people to go unassigned, because then you're sitting there and you're relying on EA to drop content, which for the past couple days, we haven't had that much content. So you're kind of just sitting there and you can't do much unless you're trying to trade like by adding cards to your squad. And that's just a pain, right? Trading with the unassigned is a pain. So yeah, if you have those high rated golds and you did a club stock, then don't worry about those just yet. If you have a couple in your transfer list, we're just waiting for SBCs to come out. Mid-icon, Neymar coming, and then possibly some player SBCs this week as well should be good for the market. But again, major things to trade with and to watch out for this week. Road to the final market movements. Look for trading with those cards. Look for some panic selling possibly if we get more news and if more people start talking about the Neymar SBC, or if we get a player of the month, Neymar or the mid-icon. Those would be some pretty, I would almost say catastrophic market movements, because that would take a lot of people away from maybe trying some of these prime icon moments, and that would push them into going out and doing an SBC. So that'd be something that I would be very, very careful with. And if you're somebody who likes to trade with these icon moments cards, these are honestly so fun to trade with. They fluctuate all the time. It's ridiculous how much they fluctuate. So get on this if you're interested. Take some risk with these, because people are trying them out and people are really used. Even guys like Laudrup, right? These cards got, some of them got insane boosts, which is making some of these cards like Laudrup pretty desirable to use. 1.5 mil for Laudrup. Like, look at this card's in-game stats. 4-star, 4-star. I think I pointed him out in a video earlier this week. This card looks pretty nuts. You know, you never really used Laudrup before, but with this stat boost, the position change, looks like a pretty solid card. So again, this week, I think Champions League is probably going to be the most important thing this week. Okay, last point on Champions League that I just forgot to mention, and I want to mention this. This happened last year, and I want to point this out to you guys, because I think it's important, because you might see this happen this week. These Team of the Group Stage cards are not live items, but there are a lot of people in this game of FIFA Ultimate Team that believe these cards are live, okay? You're going to see some of these cards go up in price after these games, because people think that they are live. Dortmund, Tottenham cards, PSG, Leipzig, Valencia, you know, Liverpool. Watch some of these cards in Team of the Group Stage. Maybe like a Ramos could go up in price. Maybe like your Salah goes up in price, because there are people that think these are live. So honestly, I'm just saying, watch these cards fluctuations. I'm not saying it's an investment point, but I'm just trying to point this out. Be aware if these cards go up in price this week for the games that are being played. That could honestly be a trading opportunity, or just something that you notice in the market and watch. So that's one last tip for you guys that I have this week as well. Watch those group stage cards, because there are people in this game that think they're alive, which is crazy, but it is what it is. So if you guys enjoyed this video, smash a thumbs up on it. Comment down below if you have any questions. And of course, subscribe to the channel if you're new. It's been Nate, the Foot Accountant. Catch you guys later. Peace.